Welcome to the demo overview video of SAP IT Operations Analytics version 2.0 support package 1. In this video we want to show the main features and how to use the software as a starting point. So if you have started the CAL image, you can log in using the username ITOAdmin and the password as defined in the Getting Started guide. So in the overview, by default, the entry page is the bucket pane. In the left navigation pane, there are further categories. There are, as we are currently, there are buckets, dashboards, alerts, attribute editor, and the analytic builder. We will come later to this, and we will start with the bucket page. Also, an existing alert we will consider later on. So let's start with the buckets at all. In general, in this demo environment, we provide demo data, which will be updated every minute, and it calculates the last 6 days and provides demo data if necessary. This means all the time, whenever you start the CAL image, he will calculate demo data on the fly. In total, we have 7 days of demo data, and the 7 days will be provided in a loop. Demo data contains two types of data. On the one side, we have syslog messages, and on the other side, we have Nagios messages, which includes notifications, alerts, and performance data. Every bucket itself can be compared with a data source. Of course, it is possible to forward and collect all the data in one bucket and manage them. At the end, this is a question how you want to organize your data and data sources. A typical data source is the standard syslog-ng message, and a lot of applications are supporting this format as well. On the right side, we have a merge bucket. This means if we have several sources and several buckets, we can merge them into one view bucket. What we have done here, we have combined these both into one merge bucket. So let's have a look in such a bucket. I will choose the Nagios bucket as an example. On the top, we have the time range selector. This means you can move into, you can drill down, and you can use presets to select a specific time range. Whatever we choose here on top, it has an influence to the attribute browser and the table view. And in the table view, you can see the raw message as a result received by ITOA. If you make a mouse over, you can also see the attributes which are generated out of the streaming data, which is prepared here for the Nagios. So we have already some attributes we can work on. And if we have attributes, we can choose them in the attribute browser to filter for events. For example, if I only want to see critical messages, I can choose an attribute with the status Nagios status, and I choose critical. Based on the time range and the chosen attribute, he will then show me the results here in the pane. Of course, if you're interested, then you can drag and drop attributes to visualize them. So this means if I, by example, add a warning. So it's a mixture of critical and warning messages. If you made a chosen, we can also create charts out of them. This means here we can choose as a symbol the amount of ideas over the time range. And then he will show me critical messages in the last 60 minutes. We can change the chart, whatever we want to choose. We can also change the time range. If we say, no, let's show me the last 6 days, then this has an influence to the chart, and he will change the chart depending on what you are choosing and what attributes you are choosing. If you are satisfied with the chart or with the table view, you have the possibility then to pin them to a dashboard. So you can create a new dashboard, or you can pin them to an existing dashboard, which brings me then to the second category. We have already prepared in this demo some dashboards, and we will choose the first one here with a landscape overview. So, this shows by example Nagios critical alerts in the last 24 hours sorted by server. So which service has the most critical alerts? So it's a waiting list. You can choose also the color here or a few by application type and so on. The same for syslog messages. So you combine different sources into one dashboard, whatever you want to see. There's an example for a specific server to get an overview. We have also a prediction part. This means you can define a specific attribute. You want to have a look on this. Here in this case, we are looking on the top side on memory values. And here below, it's the storage value. This means we are calculating the data in the past and predict the future. Here on top to looking to the future, we have also an outlier detection. This means we check the past data and analyze the normal behavior. And if something is different than comparing to the normal behavior, he will mark it as red. Here you can see that he say, here's something wrong comparing to the normal development. It's too high. And then we can trigger an alert out of them. Which brings me then to the alert page. Here we already have the outlier detection as an alert. But you can choose the alert definition and create here two simple examples, one for memory, one for storage. You can define the threshold, you can send an email, and if an alert is triggered, he will then count the amount of alerts. So in this case, here's a memory problem for server 6. And looking to the count, it looks like it happens very often. So here's a serious problem. We need to have a look into this. Another server which needs to be considered is maybe server 7 for the same problem, free memory problem. So these both have memory problems and we can have a look into this. And of course, we can also send an email, check the results. These are simple examples, but you can combine any kind of data sources. You can compare values and make more complicated queries out of them. The attribute editor is the next topic. I would like to explain it with an example. Therefore, I will go to the syslog message. And here in the syslog message, we can have a look into the existing messages. For example, this one here, I will mark it and make a mouse over. Some attributes are recognized by default, like hostname, severity, and so on. But if there are any messages or any strings I'm interested in, by example, if I want to get a check name of this, which is not included currently as an attribute, I can get this out as an attribute using the function get more insights here on the right, which brings me then to the attribute editor. He will paste the message I'm interested in. On the right side, we can see what you recognize already. With the color, you can compare which field belongs to what. But I'm interested into this message here. So I will take a part of the string to recognize this and paste it here. First of all, we need to define a name and a description. Test for demo, video by example. And this is the string I would like to get out of them. So I will define a variable out of them. Maybe check name or something like this is only an example. I need to escape some special characters. So in this case, we have a square bracket. So the square bracket needs to be escaped to be recognized. So in this case, I will add this character in front of. And for the string, he make already a succession. It's an enfoucher. I keep it as it is. Maybe it's a little bit too much. I only need 50 characters. And he make a succession for a regular expression. I take it as it is and try with the test button if it works or not. In this case, it's fine. He recognized the attribute out of them. If we need a different attribute regular expression, we have here the help where you can check existing descriptions and regular expression. What can be used here is also organized by groups in what kind we are looking for. Another opportunity you have is to check the already existing and available attributes. This means ITA comes with some predefined attributes already. And maybe we can also reuse names if there are some of them which is reusable, depends to the requirement. So as you can see, pretty simple, get out the string what I want, define them, save them, and then I can use it on the streaming data and get all the attributes out of them. So I will not save this configuration, I will keep it as it is. And I would like to come to the last option. This is the analytics builder. I will cancel this. And the analytics builder at the end is a powerful tool to create SQL queries using a graphical interface. On the left side, we have the definition pane. This means here with drag and drop and with the graphical elements, we can create queries. And on the right side, we have the result page. So let's first of all have a look to the result itself. The first object is a table with all servers and an overview about memory, storage, and CPU of the last 24 hours. The results are in percentage. And what I can do is I can mark one of them. And if I mark them, they have influence to the following objects here. So in this case, we can see now he created a chart for server 7. And maybe I will ask for displaying the last 7 days to see more information, what happens in the last 7 days in a chart. In a chart itself, we will visualize what is the used memory, storage, and CPU. So this means here, it's pretty much used for memory. So this server is working very on the limit. Also the storage with nearly 80%, 70 to 80% is very high, and some CPU activities. Here on the bottom, we have then a list of syslog and Nagios alerts into one view. If we narrow down this view, also the list and the graph will react on this and will reduce this. At the end, we have done an overview about the storage of existing storage and new storage at this time frame. This is one example how to make a deep dive or root cause analysis. If we choose another server, then the chart will be updated and show the results for this server. This configuration is called so-called a story, and this story can be then pinned to a dashboard. And this is also done here already. If I go back to the dashboards and go to the landscape, here on the bottom right, we have the story, and we can choose then here to preview the story and have then the same view what we have before, choose the server, to the specific time range, and have the result into this page. So you can use the analytics builder to prepare them and pin them then to a dashboard that other users can use it. Coming back to the definition pane, here we have the first block. This is the table with the server list. Then we have the time range selector. We have the diagram, the first one, with the performance data, storage, memory, CPU. Then we have the table with the combined list of syslog and Nagios alerts. And the last one is the storage information, total storage and used storage in a bar diagram. All these blocks you will find here on the left side. There are blocks you can drag and drop and use them and click them and search for information. Yeah, only click them and search for them. I will delete it. Functions are there, SubUI5, also the diagram is prepared from ITOA to use and create charts out of them, time range, table diagram, bindings if you want to reuse selections, logical mathematics and text and so on. So as a good starting point, you maybe can save it as a new, the existing one, and play around. So this completes the feature demo overview of SAP IT Operations Analytics. At the end, I would like to show you how to create an own bucket and how to forward your custom syslog messages into I2A. So therefore, the idea is on the left side, this is the your customer environment. You have a source server where we will forward syslog messages using this port and this communication protocol to sub-ITOA. I write down two possible problems during forwarding. One is maybe the custom firewall setting that this port is not allowed to forward message. This is a hint. This could be a problem. You need to check this. The same is in the cull image. There are also configuration options. Maybe all ports are open. Maybe the ports are not open. Please check it in the cull image if this is the case or not. But this is the second hint why maybe a message will be not forwarded. So what we will do is we will create in the ITOA solution a new bucket, configure the port, and we will enable in a source server that he can forward the messages to ITOA. So let's start here with the plus button to create a new data bucket. Let's call it custom. We choose the syslog input, which is chosen by default. And maybe we use also the attribute editor that we can then check the syslog message and create attributes out of them. Of course, you can add the features later on. It's only a succession. So he will then create a new bucket. And in the bucket, we will choose then the pencil to edit the bucket, choose the syslog server, add an adapter and configure this adapter for 1515, and I choose the TCP port. Let's start the syslog server. And now this bucket is listening on port 1515 using TCP to get messages. The only thing left now is to go to the source server, Linux server. Typically, if syslog ng is enabled, you will find, at least in SUSE Linux, it is in etc syslog ng, syslogng.conf. Here, we already paste the information. This is also described in the getting started manual, the destination, the TCP. We need to add the IP address of ITOA. You will find in the URL your IP address. So you need to enter the IP address you get from the cull image. So please don't use this IP address, port 1515. And this is the source. This means from syslog, this is per default SRC. Forward all them to this destination, to this port. If we are done with the configuration, we save it. And we will restart the service. And if everything works fine, we should then receive new messages here, which is the case. And the first message we get is that syslogng has started. So this means in the overview bucket, we will see already messages are coming in. I would like to say thank you for your attention.